I don't even know where to start, to be honest. I mean, when I really look back, I was actually playing small, taking what I was given and not living up to my true potential. And if I'm being completely transparent, I cut myself off at the legs and stunted my own career. Not sure if it was because I was scared to fail or if I was scared to win. But what became apparent was that I allowed my relationship with others to cloud my relationship with myself, which in turn left me feeling empty. Now, some people may look at poetry as just an art form, but I look at it as the very thing that saved me. So by sleeping on myself, I accepted defeat and continued to move as if I was a caterpillar, extremely afraid to morph. Fast forward, after many years of self-sabotage and having imposter syndrome, I was finally ready to step into the person I was called on this earth to be. Then just my luck, COVID hit. And with that came a change of direction. You see, I thought this change of direction was good, but in reality, it only drove me further away from the art and further away from myself. So when I received an even bigger sign from the universe to get back to the art and push, I did just that, and a butterfly was born. Welcome to No Longer a Caterpillar, a documentary by yours truly. So ideally, like how I've worked before is I lay it and then the beats are then either created around me or slapped on after me.
I feel like we had a session before in Norwood, in Gypsy Road, Fresh Beats Studio. I think that's where I've worked with you before. Yeah. Do you sing yourself there?
No.
No.
I wish. It'll be game over, poetry and singing, oh my days. It'll be a rap.
Yeah, it's deep still. Like, it's just literally what you're feeling, isn't it? Yeah.
Literally, and the thing is, it's like, and some of it, it's not even the way I feel, you know, it's what I want other people to really understand. Mm-hmm. Do you know what
you're
I mean?
You're actually
like,
trying to make people
make
think,
people
like,
think,
yeah.
You know, so,
really,
yeah.
That's cool.
So,
that's
like,
deep.
That's the energy, that's the vibe.
Best thing to do then basically is
jump in the booth,
get recording then.
Let's go.
And then from there we'll see what we can do. I'm Matik, known as A.M.P. Automatic Productions. I'm a sound engineer and sometimes a producer. When Telixia first came to the studio, I was very intrigued. I've never really worked with spoken word before. I was a fan of a spoken word group back in the day called Flowetry, so I was really, really intrigued and interested to get involved with something like that.
So, I don't really know, like, I haven't been in the booth since 2019. So getting back in the studio to record and get this project out is, yeah, it's dope because this is my special place. This is my happy place. Putting out content that is inspiring, that's thought-provoking, that's like, yo, raw shit. This is different. Makes me happy. So, yeah, I thought it would be cool to just get some behind the scenes to see, like, how I do it and yeah, just kind of bring you guys on the journey with me a little bit, you know what I mean? But yeah, so this project is got 10 tracks. My biggest project yet, because my last project Poet was 4 tracks, I think, 5 tracks, could be wrong. But this has got 10 tracks and hopefully it'll be coming with some visuals. And yeah, I just hope like you guys enjoy it, to be fair.
Many people fall victim to their own circumstances, forgetting that there is strength in vulnerability. We all go through hardship to some degree, but sometimes it's better to use a bird's eye view to see. Turning your pain into your purpose can be your reality.
your feelings, who your purpose can be, your reality. Taking responsibility for the actions is the first step.
We all go through hardship to some degree, but sometimes it's better to use a bird's eye view to see. Turning your pain into your purpose can be your reality.
My first thought was, I do not produce. But obviously I can't hide away from the fact that I have produced before, innit? So to help someone out, if they can see the vision in me, then I can't really deny it, innit? So yeah, it was a challenge, but it was something that I was really intrigued to see what the end result would be like. Fun. It was really fun working with Telixia, man. It's just one of those ones where it's like, it feels like all the barriers are down and we're literally just bouncing off each other and just working, and there's no sort of politics or anything. Like, we're just literally just having fun and working towards the end goal. So yeah, it was sick.
Cool. So I'm thinking about the whole thing.
Yeah.
To get me that to 10 as one. So it'd be nice if maybe one was slow, like.
Okay.
Do you know what I'm saying? Like, if there's a one that's actually gonna make people nearly cry, then slow that one down.
Okay.
And then we can just do pianos and just something beautiful. Like
that.
Just...
Pain doesn't equal failure. It is a feeling that is subjective to a feeling. But turning your pain into your purpose is the ultimate sense of heat.
Hard. Very hard still. I said this is very hard still.
Yeah.
Thank
you.
Hard still.
If we do, like, because then if we do start building instrumental-wise, we can sort of make them flow into each other type thing.
So, but then wouldn't that not just be one track?
No, I can split it in the end. Oh. Yeah. Okay. And at the end, okay. I can bounce it out as different tracks. Yeah,
that's cool.
Yeah. Personally, it made me feel sick. Still dope. Like I said, I rarely go to like events and stuff like that, especially events that I'm involved in with the music. So to see the people's response, it was inspiring, man. It was sick.
It's time to pursue your passion. If you can't stop thinking about it,
society tells you that you must attend university, but look at those millionaires without a degree. The system doesn't educate, it indoctrinates, which makes it easier to penetrate a weak mind, while the marginalized survive on food banks and petty crime. Some not so petty. Youth shake up society with violence and robberies. Money is the root to all evil, so manage it.
It's
easy to blame others for all the bad things that transpired, not realizing all that transpired allowed you to get fired.
This might be one.
Man that believed in it. I ask you one question. Do you want to sink or swim? The answer you give will allow others to think. And the dreams you possess that help you stay awake. Fear is the ultimate dream killer. Don't.
Yeah, that one is the cup.
But dream killer. Don't get led astray.
I wanted to turn non-believers of the art into believers. Mm-hmm. And obviously, and the one thing that gravitates people to different things is music, right?
Mm.
So they're bound to listen to this woman if it's got something that they're used to.
Weak man, regular sex, good food, and a great time.
Yeah.
His ambitions away. It just reminds me of all those dogs that stray. No reason for
personally, going back to the flowetry thing, I'd love to see Telixia do some more work, like collaborations with like singers, maybe rappers as well. I think that would be cool.
Capitalism is the very thing that wins every time.
So, my first single is called Economics, and I'm gonna get some clothes for the video shoot.
Society with violence and robberies.
But I ain't even guided that far. My brother ain't even strong like that yet, you get me? Not even cutting up them things. Need to get the house first. But, alright, cool. So, today, we are documenting the process, yeah? And I think a lot of people don't really showcase
their real journey. That's it. So I've got a new project coming out, hopefully this year. It's called Educating the Masses, so ETM. And I want to kind of document the journey, you know. Obviously, we're going to my favorite store is Zara. Please don't talk to me about, you know, how they sold their clothes and all of these things. I'm not really interested in that at this precise moment. I just need to get my drip, and that is a bit of me, wherever they are. So basically, yeah, I'm a masculine presenting female, so I just skip past all the feminine clothes and go straight to men's section. Do you know what's hard there? Being a masculine presenting female, like, you go straight to the men's section, you pick out your garment, and you have to come all the way downstairs to the women's fitting room, which is long. And then they're looking at you like, okay. So economics is about capitalism. It's about wealthy and poor, and just really understanding like how deep that shit is, isn't it? So in the visual, I'm trying to present as a wealthy person and a poor person to kind of show the different dynamics.
Not on
another wealthy person dressed like. Because you know what I realized, yeah? It's the most wealthiest people that dress the most subtle. Do you get it? So that's also what I've got to take into consideration, isn't it? I don't want to be out here looking like some old man in some grey up suit. Like,
ooh, this is a bit of me. This is a bit of me.
What do they have pants? No?
Probably pants. That is
a bit of me. This is why I should have come shopping, you know? This is a bit of me, you know? Alright, listen, yeah, I spend so much rats in this place that sponsorship's due, bro. Yeah? Male presenting women smashing the modelling thing on your thing. Obviously, I think I'm just at an age where I want my swag to kind of represent the person I am. Do you know what I mean? So, I need to make sure I've got those in a size 6. Like, the type of jeans that I like to wear, they have to have character. They definitely have to have character. They don't have my size. Don't be asking what my size is. They have got big bumpy. Yes, I'm one of them people that took back marathon. So sorry to talk.
The UK isn't far behind the United States. Capitalism is the very thing that wins every time. It's the people at the top that
are coming out like the clothes is wearing me, I ain't wearing the clothes. Kind of easy things. Like, you know, people that see go out, yeah, and their clothes just look stupid.
What are you doing to provide opportunities? When we build businesses, are we employing those from our community? It's time to wake up from our sleep. We must no longer be sheep.
Educating the masses. We out soon. Make sure you stream, make sure you follow, make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel. And economics. Economics is gonna be lit. Got my outfits ready for the video shoot for economics that I'll be shooting in a couple of weeks. So I'm excited, I'm happy. I just can't wait for you guys to see it and be a part of this journey. Stay tuned, educating the masses. Make sure you follow, subscribe, tell a friend, and just support the kid.
My name is Paul, creative, and I'm a social media content creator, and I specialize in photography. Because I love what I do, so when someone approaches me and they believe in my talent, it's a privilege to help bring to life their project with my talent.
about educating the masses. Are the masses.
My name's Rico Inico. I'm a dog breeder slash trainer. When I first heard the project, I was happy because my little sister's doing something good.
She's getting comfortable now.
Not at all, no. We went back and forth, spoke about our ideas. She told me what she wanted, and then I gave my input, and yeah, we made it happen. Seeing everyone's reaction to the finished product, and you know, like hearing T's ideas, and then actually seeing it come to life and seeing how receptive everyone was of it.
So what I think the image that I'm looking for, yeah, I think the artwork, I want the artwork to be maybe with the dog, me looking quite serious, but maybe even not looking at the camera. I think that would be a good image.
I was anxious and nervous.
Hey T,
I had to interrupt my gym session just to talk to you, man. I'm listening to your project now as I'm in the gym. You can even hear me puffing and puffing. I had to interrupt, man. Listen, you're amazing, man. That's all I have to say.
It's time to pursue your passion. If you can't stop thinking about it for one day, then it's time to start planning. Your passion can take you to places you never thought you'd be. It can show you things that you'd never thought you'd see. If only you took your passion way more seriously. It could open doors and you'd be the driving force you was meant to be. Society makes you believe that a 9-to-5 is the only way to be.
I didn't even know it was going to be on the billboard. So when she messaged me and sent me the picture, it was like, rah, like, yeah, this is sick. Yeah.
Bust my tags, car. I'm not taking them back. You get me? I'm not one of them ones. Buy and take back. You get me? So the project's coming. You to go put clothes for me. Later, there's only one person I want to work with who's a stylist. Her name's Ashley. You see me, yeah? Like, I'm a vibe, innit? I'm a whole vibe. This is no liquor, no drug induced. This is just natural, just from the gut. You get me? So, this is the first look.
Yeah, red carpet vibes. For everything that we've been doing to come out, you know what I mean? Like, what you see, like the shoots, the image and all of that is all a part of a bigger vision, do you know what I mean? Like, I just can't wait for the project to land. I'm so excited. This is the hardest I've ever worked. Like, I work hard when I go in the studio, but I mean, in terms of visuals, in terms of content, in terms of giving my supporters and people that don't know me a chance to really see what I can do with this kind of art. Beautiful. So I'm just enjoying the process, you know?
My name is Kara, you also know me as Kayla Scribbles. I am a global partnerships director and I also founded my management company, Kayla Scribbles Limited. I booked Telixia's studio space that she had, I think, over a year ago now, maybe, for another artist that I manage, and there was just a natural synergy. We just connected. Telixia realised that I was the manager, and then, we had a conversation over the phone, and then that was it. It was just a natural born connection.
All lives can't matter until the white officer with the badge can see past our skin colour. Hundreds of years ago, we were slaves to a nation.
This is the second look, you know, something just light, less is more, but more, you get me? I'm giving gangster rapper.
While the marginalised survive on food banks and petty crime,
included in the seating plan?
Not really.
Because, oh, hold on, you've changed. This has changed.
Well, who's on? Is it just you on stage?
So it'll be me and my host. So how it works, we'll have someone to come and open the show.
Okay.
And then we'll have the saxophonist playing while people like are ordering and eating and stuff. And then my bit of the show will start. And it's more so like, not like a podcast, but like an interview kind of thing where I'm going to be playing each of my tracks and then talking about the project. So it's like, it's a private listening party. But this is so nice here when people are just sitting here because I'm going to be on the stage and stuff.
Mm.
So it'd be really nice just to like have the like front row and then, do you know what I mean?
Nice.
space.
Okay, it's a nice space, isn't it? Like, exactly for what I wanted. I wanted it to be quite intimate, nice lighting.
It's intimate,
quite
but it's not stupidly crap.
Exactly. Do you know what I mean? I wanted people to come out and feel like they're actually coming to like a nice intimate show with like their partner or their family. Like, that's the kind of vibe I wanted. So this is definitely perfect for that.
Okay, so this is the dressing room. Oh, yeah. This is nice. Oh, wow. Okay, this is sweet. So yeah, this is sweet.
And you can find a spot to sign like everybody else has.
Wicked, I'll definitely do that.
Oh, we'll sign in. We didn't have this at the academy.
I'm big on energy, and the first time I met Telixia, even before I met Telixia, the way how the book in the studio space was handled, I thought, hey, this is good. I knew it was black. I didn't know Telixia personally. When I just felt energy between us, and when we had the phone conversation, I think we was on the phone for, I don't know, maybe an hour, 2 hours, and we were just talking about everything, and I just understood what point of her life she was in, and I knew what point I was in, and I just knew that something naturally organic that could be quite beautiful would be born out of it. And I'm just here for real, genuine people that genuinely believe in themselves. Because I think when you manage someone, if they don't believe in themselves, it's a very hard relationship to kind of nurture and build. So yeah, I saw the real authentic drive and hunger in Telixia, and I believe in her, I believe what she stands for, I believe in her journey thus far and her story. So that's what made me say yes.
Pixie Lott's been educating the masses is out, and being able to put together a private listening party in partnership with Pizza Express was an amazing experience. And it just kind of goes to show that, you know, brands and companies of this magnitude can support spoken word in the way that we need them to. With this partnership, like, I just want to be able to open doors and give people the opportunity to see that it can be done. And not only that, like, you know, we can reach for the stars with our art, so it's just always about making sure that you're connecting the dots and connecting with the right people that's going to empower you to do greatness with what you really want to do and to push your passion forward. So, you know, having this partnership with Pizza Express, that it's done just that. So I can't wait for you guys to really, like, see what we're doing. Is key. Yeah. Any creative, you can't do it on your own. Oh, man, step. Woo!
Alright.
Your team's the desk off.
Alright.
That's your space. You got extra.
Oh, sweet. Okay.
Well, I think these came out sick.
Be fearless. Yeah? Or whatever you do, be fearless. Art. So this year is actually one of my poems. That's from the project. Yeah, so it was amazing that I was able to even get this. Like, the Fireprint Studio, they proper pulled through for me. And I'm in awe of it, man. Fear is an illusion we are all taught to acknowledge. Remember that saying. That looks cold. Yeah, I like that still. Oh, Wes, I'm in awe of you, bro. This is my first ever two-piece collection. And this collection is called Be Fearless. That's what this collection is called.
That's the one I'm wearing. That's a daily drop.
In it.
Yeah, on the black, I figured this looks
good. Yeah. Alright, so I had this design created, yeah, and on the computer, I liked what it looked like, but when it came out on print, it just
wasn't given what it was supposed to be given. And what I like is that the team, you know, Wes and the team, they came back to me and they said, look, this is what it looks like. What do you think? My opinion is this. What do you think? And our opinions were in line, do you know what I mean? And I like that because this is something new to me. I'm able to get ideas and they're able to give me the advice that's needed for it to be amazing, do you know what I mean? So now I can go back to this and say, actually, let's remove the cloud because on print, because I've seen it, it doesn't work. But the messaging is still powerful. And when you're looking at collaborations and you're looking at how to work with people, it's important that you take on professionals' advice because this is their field, it's not my field. So just basically having the expertise of the team really, really helped. So that was the artwork that never came to light. It's like, as an artist, there's so many different elements that you have to do in order to feel like you're truly fulfilling your purpose, right? So this is the first time I've ever got merch, I've ever gone to this extent with any project. So when this project lands, I hope that the world and the people, like, it really resonates with them. But then also, what's beautiful about this, because as poets, we sometimes have imposter syndrome. We sometimes look at other artists and think, oh, they're doing activations, they're doing tours, they're doing this, and that's something that we can't do. But I'm here to let you know we can. We just need to find our tribe, and that's how we can vibe. We need to know that our core supporters are going to buy into whatever we're selling and buy into us and buy into our art. So by having merch, I'm able to, number one, have another revenue stream, but then also be able to show that the poetry, the art, the sound can be transferred onto clothing, which is universal because everybody needs clothes and everybody wears clothes. So yeah, so poets, get your merch done. Check out Fireproof Studio. They help me bring my vision to life. You know, they're super cost effective and they're just good people and they're just, they can help with every step of the way. Sweet.
Okay. Yo, are you listening, yeah? I've been anxious for the past, like... It's been really bad.
Yeah, you have?
It's been really bad.
My name's Amanda Starr. I'm a host, presenter, voiceover artist. I work with children. And I am also the founder of a platform called Young Black Shining Star, which is a platform that promotes, celebrates, honours, inspires children of Black origin under 18. I first heard about Telixia Inico, the one, the only, through Cara, who is an absolute godsend to anybody that is in her life. Yes, because I was asked to host her private listening of her project, Educating the Masses.
Do you think the merch table should be on this side and the banner should be more in instead of the banner being there because people are wanting to take pictures?
Yeah.
So then, alright, so.
This is to put it up, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh.
have to say, I was listening to the project on my way here.
Yeah.
And I genuinely felt like I was in a therapy session.
Oh, shit.
No, but a good one. Okay. It was actually really good. I'm really excited for people to listen to it and to kind of really take it in. So what we're going to do is we are going to go through each track. And then myself and Telixia are going to talk about the track. Mm-hmm. And what we would like you to do is rate each track.
When I first heard the project, I was blown away. And it made me think that Telixia as an artist is needed in this world. Because, you know, just the content of her art is, I think, is very important for people to, you know, listen to, all ages as well. I think that was one of the things that I really liked about the project, is that it wasn't just for a certain demographic, if that makes sense. It's like literally anybody could hear it and anybody could take it in, because it would resonate with what anyone's going through at any time in their journey of life.
Telly, I couldn't be more proud of you, honestly. I think all of us in this room are just extremely, just, I'm blown away. I can't even lie. I expected amazingness, but this is like phenomenal. Yeah. Do you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, this is, yeah, your Grammys are coming. But to me, it feels like you talked us through a journey to get to number 10. Yeah. Do you feel like that was kind of?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And yet again, that's all about why they're so short. You know what I mean? Why the way they are, why the words, you know, why the titles are the titles. It's all about the journey. And I feel like people think the journey is, like the journey is the most important thing. Forget the destination. Yeah. It's the humps, the bumps, it's all of that. That's what builds character. And that's what we need to understand. Like, we see Instagram and we think that it's just, it's quick, it's microwavable. My thing's not microwavable, my thing's timeless.
Jeez! Yeah. I'm under the sun!
Well, my first thoughts were yay! Because, you know, I love hosting. I think it's the time that I shine the most. But at the same time, obviously I never knew who Telixia was, and Cara got in touch with me to see if I was available, and it was actually on the actual day of the event. So, you know, for me, that will always be special, because it was the first time that I met Telixia. It was the first time that I heard any of, you know, her art, so to speak. And for me, I will always remember it as it being the beginning of our like relationship journey now, because, you know, Telixia is my girl for life, you get me? But at the same time, I'm a great believer in things happen for a reason. So, you know, even the fact that I was asked last minute just goes to show that it was meant to be. So for that, I am very, very grateful. I feel blessed and thankful that, I was asked, and it was the beginning of a great relationship.
What is your writing process? Do you write first? Do you hear the beat? Like, who's the producer? Like, what's going on? Because I think sonically, like, I'm listening, first of all, as a DJ, so I'm listening to the actual music, and then I'm listening to the vocal, I'm listening to the mastering, I'm listening to the level of the music and how much music I can hear compared to how much vocal. Like, it, to me, I'm not just saying this because I'm your friend, but it's perfection to me.
Yeah.
The balance between the music and the vocal and everything in between it. So how do we put this together? Tell us.
So I write first, and then I look at my phone and I say, who can I connect with who can help me get this together? And the person who helped me get this together was actually Bouncer.
Yo, my people, my name is Myles Harris, and everybody knows me as Bouncer. A lot of people get confused, but I was a music manager I'll just say that I'm in the entertainment world. I'm a boxing promoter. I have a platform called Wicked and Bad. And yeah, we're pushing this entertainment, spoken words, music, boxing, everything in one. Listen, Telixia, listen, I know her from like Chipset days, you get me? So you don't even, if you don't know about Chipset, then from years ago, from when we were like 13, 14. So, and listen, we was on the roads, we was outside, and obviously watching her grow and working with her on many projects. Both of my documentaries, Come Up 1, the Come Up 2, the Come Up mixtape, Wicked and Bad, the Bouts and Arms Fight, Wicked and Bad 3. You should know how special she is too, and how much I value her, like her talent and how she is. I always call her that. I just rate her, man.
So we've done a lot of work together. I've been on previous mixtapes of his and stuff. And he had the Come Up documentary 2 coming out, and he said, listen, the doc's dropping, you like the people need to hear what you got coming, so you need to put a project together. I said, oh shit, okay. Mm-hmm. Pressure.
I would like to see Telixia on TV. Like, I would like to see her on TV. I would like to see her touring, like touching people's souls, like through the love of spoken word, through her art. And I can see, like, the UK is not her ceiling. She needs to go to America, because you go to America, you will see like how big you can actually be. And sometimes we're in the UK, and it's just like music artists, their ceiling is thinking getting a million views on that platform. But when you come out of the when you go to another country, you realize like how big and how much more opportunity it is. So I know I would like to see her touring around the world, and I would like to see her on TV.
I've never really listened to spoken word before. I'm sold. What I've heard today is trailblazing. It really is. The way that you've done it, you've taken us on a full journey. So many different emotions. We've laughed, we've been a bit teary. And just the way you've done as well, even just the way that you've done short, you know, short samples as well. And you know what? Well done to you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Like, seriously, you are a star. Like, you are amazing. And this project is I don't think, like, I've been in the entertainment business, like hosting, obviously doing radio before and everything, for a very long time, and it's been a very long time that I've actually come across an artist that I'm like, shit, like, wow. Do you understand what I mean? Like, every single word. And shouts out to the producer as well. Is it Matik? Like, yeah. Seriously? Now, make some noise.
The only advice I can give her is just keep doing what you're doing. I swear down, like, it's one of them things where I know it might sound like a corny answer, but bro, literally, you're doing everything that I see artists not doing, you're doing it times 10. So yeah, just keep doing what you're doing. Sick.
So this is actually going to be the first time you're going to see me perform.
Yes. Oh, it's good, man. It's a good thing. You'll be fine. Don't think about us. Don't look at me.
I thought Telixia's one of a kind. I've never heard anything like this. I used to be a poet, funnily enough. Not many people know this, but I used to actually be a poet. So when I heard Telixia's work, the delivery from the way it was written, it being over music, and just the way her voice kind of makes the content come alive, I was just blown away. I was just like, wow, I've never heard anything like this, never seen anybody like her as well, from a, you know, from a physical, visual perspective. So yeah, just blown away.
Well, genius from last time. I wish.
I think I'm gonna come from that side.
From
I'm gonna come from that side.
And she's amazing. She did wicked. You see, you didn't recognise me from before. You see, but I recognise you.
See, the thing is, I love a challenge. So anything that's a challenge, I don't actually view as a challenge. But I think Telixia's mind is a very interesting place. It's a very special place. And I think sometimes she has a lot going on in her mind and she doesn't communicate that to me. And obviously I'm here to support and I'm here to help. So sometimes if she doesn't tell me something, then, or she may tell me after the thought has happened or after she made a decision, I'm like, why didn't you tell me so we could have sorted this out, or we could have spoken about it. So I would say that could be, I guess, a challenge in some sense. But I think with time, when you build a new relationship, I think obviously there's absolutely a trust between us, but I think that's only going to continue to get stronger. And obviously there's a responsibility on my part as well to obviously make that space for her to feel like she can just, you know, say whatever. And we already have these conversations, like, Telixia knows I know how her mind works, and I just allow her to be herself. So yeah, I think just, yeah, sometimes she keeps things in her mind and then her mind goes to space and back. And then I'm like, we could have actually solved the journey to space if we just actually discussed.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for us to bring out our next guest this evening, a spoken word artist performing Blades and Roses. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Telixia Inico.
Blades and a red rose. Place a young boy under a headstone. Bury him when he is barely grown. Wipe the tears from his daughter's cheekbone. Not all those affected by knife crime are gang tied. Let's try wrong day, wrong time. Blades and a red rose is the language real bangers live by. Being affiliated doesn't make you any less of a good guy. I'm sick of seeing parents forced to say goodbye. Their kids' names turned into a hashtag. Go fund a funeral. No insurance or reassurance for these young boys' lives. Place a rose by a fallen soldier's graveside. Blades and roses.
Telixia Inico.
Thank you for being a reflection to me. Like, just thank you for being a dope human being, like, who isn't scared to tell the world what she wants and tell the world where she's going. And even though you will get scared along the way, because the fears get bigger and bigger as your career does, and I can see your career actually excelling now, do you know what I mean? And just pushing through, because that's what you deserve. And yeah, I'm proud, man.
One of the studios that I got access to in Croydon, and I kind of see it in, like I said, with a mirror and me just like talking into it, and then that being edited in a nice creative way. I don't know what that looks like because that's your area, but like, I can see myself in the mirror. It's like I'm talking to myself, but thinking about it.
And the camera is shooting over your shoulder, and we can see the mirror, and we can see the top of your shoulder,
okay.
And you're actively talking to this version of you?
Yes. I feel like people need to see me in like different stages, and I need to show them where I'm going.
Do you think something like on a nice day, me potentially just walking in somewhere like Kew Gardens, I don't know if you can you do a shot from up there, like is it drone? Like a drone shot of me walking in nature. I don't really know, but that's what I kind of hear from this. Like, it's pain, but I don't really want to focus so much on the pain. I want to focus on like life and
growing.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't really know what I'm doing, but I'm just doing it. I never even thought yet when I started this process that it was going to be this big or even this long. Like, I didn't anticipate how much work this is. Like, some people just think, oh, you write your lyrics or you write your pieces and then you work with a producer and then it's done, but there's so much behind the scenes that people don't can realize, man. It's intense, mentally, emotionally, and even physically. It's magic.
More of what you're doing now, just keep pushing forward. Like, we want to see more products, like more projects, and much more. Like, I want T to phone me and be like, yeah, I got a live show. I want you to photograph it. That's what we want to see.
I'm Daniel Justine, I'm a designer and creator. I actually met Telixia through Dapo, a good friend of mine, business partner. He was doing a shoot for one of the artists of his, and we happened to get taken down to her studio where we both met, and the vibe and energy was just great, and from then we showed support to each other and the relationship just grew from there.
No, this is cool. He done the photography, and then Daniel done like the design of the artwork. But it was just like, it was important for me that they also get their credit on this campaign.
Because putting in the work.
Over the moon. Telixia could see it for herself. I was gassed, man. I was gassed for both of us. One, our names are on there, you know, it's a creation we'd all put together as well as the photography. And it's just great to see a project that you've got so much passion about lived out in the full and people can take it in.
Keep doing what you're doing. You're doing an amazing job. It's inspiring, especially to a lot of the young. Definitely true words. Keep it up. I'm so proud to even see you on the billboard. Yeah, I want to walk past her and say, yeah, that's my sister. That's my little sister. So keep it up.
Well, it was a no-brainer because we'd worked together on economics previously and that process was amazing. Like, to work with someone with that kind of energy, that kind of mindset, it just kind of put me in the zone of like, yeah, this is someone I would like to stay in contact with, build up my kind of work with and my portfolio and see what she's doing and support that too. So it was definitely a no-brainer.
I'm in my butterfly era right now. Literally, I'm telling you. I feel it too. It's the energy, man.
So grateful for Telixia giving my son this opportunity.
Right. What size do you think you are? Is that the fit? Yeah.
My name's Martha and I'm Telixia's really, really good friend. I was happy that she asked for me. I am only a teacher. I'm not a model. I'm not within the creative industry. So for her to be, for her to ask me to be part of her journey physically, I was, it was an instant yes. And I was excited. I was excited to be part of it.
I never thought about putting together a real collection before. It's only when I done the hoodies and I was like, actually, you know what? Like, let me try something new, try something different, but really give it meaning this time. Because even down to what it says, you know what I mean? It's just where I am at in my life, but also I feel like a lot of people are there as well.
I want to create.
I like a thing where like the t-shirt can go with different brands and stuff, right?
So today we are down at the WeWorker studio shooting the content for Liberty, my new lifestyle brand. This is going to be the first collection called No Longer a Caterpillar, which is the butterfly effect. And I've got some dope people down here shooting and doing some pics for the website and also for social media to get us off to the right track. So this is just another element to the Telixia Inico brand. Stay tuned.
Me, the photographer. Go by Reese or Frame, whatever you want to call me. But yeah, we work in town. I'm just cleansing the air, making sure everyone's got the right positivity in that. I like to sage down the equipment before I use it. That's just how I roll.
Proud. 100% proud. I felt like this year T's been able to find who she really is. It makes me happy to see everything that she's doing, being able to be in there physically, watching her on social media, the views that she gets, the feedback that she gets, and her work overall. Yeah, it just makes me proud. Happy, happy.
Because I'm able to work with real people. I'm able to work with people that are passionate about the brand, passionate about growing, passionate about being the best version of themselves. And I think that is what makes Liberty and the Butterfly Effect collection an amazing one. By Liberty.
You're an amazing woman. You know, you've achieved so much since you have started your journey with poetry, and loving your energy, loving everything about you, and just sending you all the positive energy and the love from me and the boys all the way to you. Love you.
The Butterfly Effect collection coming soon. We are no longer caterpillars, we are butterflies.
I want to see her perform more. I feel like her work is great. Her visuals when they come out there, sick. Can't wait for all that to come out. But I want her to do more live shows, which I know she doesn't really like to do. So that's what I'd like her to see. I would like to see her do more of.
I'm exceptionally proud of you. I know we haven't known each other for the longest of time, but honestly, your vibe, your energy, your everything. Like, the world needs more of you, for real. And I love you so much.
Who's ready to be inspired? Put your hands up if you're ready to be inspired!
Oh. You're making magic, bro.
Okay.
Yeah, I see. That's not a little bit in mind. It's looking good, but it's looking real good.
So, what's happening?
Outfit change.
But what's happening with the...
I think we might end up using...
The bathroom. Do you think?
I think so.
We are at the second location.
We're going to be in the second
video for educating the masses.
So we're going to do one take, and the first take is going to be your performance in the mirror.
Yeah.
And then we're going to
Take two is going to be your reaction. So you're going to be taking it all in, absorbing the information you're delivering. And then we're going to slice it down the middle and we're going to morph reaction. Second take, you're receiving the message she's delivering. So you're like, I shouldn't have that. You know what? You know what? Point yourself. I'm you.
Yeah.
First take is mirror Tanisha.
Yeah.
Speaking to Tanisha. Tanisha. Right?
Okay.
So the first take, you're going to be preaching. Yes.
Okay.
You put yourself second and make others a priority. I ask you one question. Do you want to sink or swim?
I'm doing all that, innit?
Yeah.
You put yourself second and make others a priority. I ask you one question. Do you want to sink or swim?
I was blown away, to be honest. She didn't let me listen to it prior to doing the artwork, which I'll still cuss her about to this day. But to be honest, it was worth the wait. When was there in the listening live performance, everyone was just taken aback. It was cohesive. It was the first time I've actually listened to a full spoken word project as well, and it's an unlimitless art form, so everyone needs to take it in.
Yo, listen, yeah? 10 tracks. 10 tracks. 10 visuals. I don't know artists that do that. And now this is the last video we're doing, and this is for Lost. This concept is pretty straightforward, simple, but effective. I can't wait for you to see it.
The truth hurts. So when we tend to gravitate to things that don't challenge us to see it, we know that we need reality, but fantasy seems way more appealing. Serious issues under the carpet becoming emotionally constipated to acknowledging hardship.
Fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. Tanisha's put on her best performance, hasn't hesitated, hasn't missed the lyric.
So, just finished shooting a video for Lost. It was definitely out of my comfort zone, but I'm happy that I did do it. It was a last minute change, but you know, these things happen in the industry that we're in. Sometimes things change like that and we have to get to it. I'm just happy that, you know, I had the team around me to be able to help me through it, but definitely excited for you guys to see it. Lost, here we go. Oi oi.
Into spaces that it's never been. I think that's already started in some aspects, because even from the private listening party, the way that people engaged with that, and I think the story and the message that Tanisha has in her music, or spoken word pieces, sorry, it's different. And I think for any spoken word artist that I've seen thus far, I haven't seen them do what I know Tanisha's going to do. And I think all the projects that we're working on and everything that we're going to take between here and 2 years, 5 years, 10 years, I'm going to see her being as big as, you know, because I think a lot of spoken word artists are not seen the same as a singer or a rapper or an actor or actress or anything like that. But I think the level that we're going to take Tanisha, she's going to be given the same recognition and credit as those that are singers and rappers and artists.
It's been amazing! Hey! So this girl just matches my energy. Seriously, as I said, it was the first time I had met her when I hosted her private listening. And it was so funny because I actually mentioned it during the evening and the audience was actually shocked because we just had a natural, like, our energies just matched. And I think it was just very hard for everybody to believe that we actually only just met each other on that day. So, yeah, man, she is a light that's needed in this world.
So, what's up? We're trying to figure out lighting today. Right, we're shooting in the dark, so lighting is very, very important. Are we going to use this or that? Maybe this. Maybe we've just got complete darkness, who knows? I'm just going to go with this. One here. Drop in.
This
said the camera adds £10 to you, isn't it?
Is my dread, my dreads dreading? Like, is this alright? I'll be like 80% there.
This track is number one ingredient and it's featuring Princess K. We're doing a dark interrogation concept. Me talking to, I guess, like the younger version of myself.
Yeah,
perspective.
The lighting now looks good.
Yeah, I'm so tired. I'm so sorry. I know normally I'm giving you like big energy. Do you get me?
From the ground, just, like, it wasn't. The illuminated face.
We were meant to start at 8:30, and it is basically 11 o'clock or something. But I reckon, like,
tell you what,
I'm gonna do it in like one take. I don't know, but we're getting to it. You know, these things happen. It's a process. You can't rush creativity and greatness.
Which makes it easier to penetrate a weak mind. Feeling happy, believe.
Well done, princess.
We did it. It's a wrap. Yeah. Video 8 done. And basically, video 9 is in the bag. Educating enough.
It's time to chase your passion.
See what I want.
Cream. Yeah, the cookie. One goodie bag done. All right, how should I put these? Should I put them
In front?
Or
because the chair won't stay down, would it?
No, yeah, it will.
Will it?
Well, it'll be like that.
Yeah, that's fine, yeah.
Yeah?
That's cool.
Today we are down at Kino Bermondsey for the official screening of Educating the Masses. I am going to be showcasing all 9 visuals to this project and I'm extremely gassed. I've worked so hard to bring this to life and I just can't wait for everyone to see it. Make sure when it lands, you're sharing, you're commenting, you're liking, and you're telling a friend because it is truly, truly amazing.
Educating the Masses!
I definitely think the type of art she created needed, Telixia created needed. You got to remember, if I'm a person that I would always post on Snapchat or I would always put up quotes. So people will follow me just for my quotes. Then you might have people following me just for my banner. So people, you touch people, innit? And some people might be in a dark place. And when I'm in a dark place, I listen to your art. Do you know what I mean? I listen to it. So. It's definitely needed and it definitely helps with mental health and it's definitely very different.
I think teen art is very thought-provoking and it draws out your emotions.
I think she is an amazing artist and there is great power in her journey so far and in the way that, you know, she expresses, you know, kind of like what she's been through her art.
I think it's unique and I think it's something that the world needs. I think the state of the world now, I'm sure you probably everyone will agree, it's a hot mess. And I think art is an escapism for everybody. And I think with Telixia's art, I think a lot of people can relate, even those that probably don't realise it, and I guess they probably wouldn't. Some people are like, oh, I don't really use the spoken word for whatever reason. But I think with Telixia's art, it's so poignant and I think it's quite palatable in a lot of different areas that I think it's something that the world needs. So people can really hear the message behind it, because like I said, the world is a mess. And there's a lot of people that, from each different demographic, from whether you're, you know, a teenager to an adult, and even whatever stage you're in, if you're building a business, if you're a single mum, first-time mum, I don't know, ex-gang member, whatever you are, there's a lot that you can relate to within the art. So I think it's special art, and I think a lot of people need to hear it.
She's doing very positive things, and I'm just proud of her, and I want to tell her that I love her.
Mesmerizing. Everyone's got to take it in. Like, everyone actually has to deep what she's saying and the stuff that she's providing to the public, because not every artist is going to say stuff like this. Not everyone's got that kind of proudness about what they're speaking about and understanding that this is to change a whole generation and its community. It's all community based. The people around her, the people that she interacts with, it all comes through her art. So you're blessed to be able to show people that.
So yeah, I think Telixia's art is like, it's good because it's thought provoking. I feel like that's kind of what separates it from maybe a lot of modern music nowadays, is that sometimes maybe you're just dancing to the song and there's not really no thoughts getting provoked. But with this, it's definitely something that I feel like it forces you to become self-reflective. So it's very dope.
Continue working in your purpose, living in your purpose. Understand that I'm proud of you. I tell you this all the time. Your word for this year was consistency, and I feel like you've been consistent throughout. And again, you've been an inspiration to myself. I know you'll be an inspiration to many others and the younger generation coming up. So yeah, keep doing what you're doing.
Little little butterfly, what you do all day? I roam around the flowers and all the sunshine around me. Pretty little butterfly, what you do all day? Mm. So you're not easy. Mm.